All right, coming up next, it's a light heavyweight matchup between The Last Style Bender, Israel Adesanya, and John Jones.
Ready? Are you ready?
All right, so the fight is underway. We will see how it plays out. It's a pick'em fight according to Las Vegas, and really hard to think of a weakness that we have seen on film from either guys in their UFC careers.
I feel like both of these guys are the top of the food chain. They're the best of the best that we could put inside the octagon. They are so well-rounded. They have every skill, and that is going to be on display tonight in this key matchup.
Oh, he's got the knee on the belly. Could be trouble defensively. Working out of side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you got to be careful here. Oh, he knees the body here inside mount. Nicely played.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. And this might just be a matter of time. Not tapping out tonight. Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now, because you get to make your opponent decide. They try to turn back into you, you can attack guillotines. If they turn away to try to get to your knees, you throw your hooks in, and you got all your rear choke submissions.
All right, north-south position now. We'll see how he chooses to proceed. Oh, wow, that happened quickly as the fighter reverses position there on the ground.
Unbelievable position change. Wow, what a transition.
Well, there are few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High level grappling can really be entertaining.
Andy lands the knee to the body now. Oh, another knee right to the midsection. Well, you see all the grappling repetitions here. Just beautiful movement, seamless transitions on the ground.
Over and over, these guys are doing things that you see in every jiu-jitsu gym around the country.
Oh, nicely done there as he escapes back to his feet. Looks like he's trying to set up a takedown here. There's the attempt. Oh, nice connection there by John Jones. And he is fighting with a definite killer instinct here tonight.
And you have to have it, because the target's always on your back when you're the UFC champion. Jones.
Shot there, DC, and one more of those.
I mean, the fight is going to be over. I can't believe he's still standing. That shot landed perfectly.
Jones going for the takedown. Nothing doing there.
Nice, great punch.
So a strong 5 minutes down. All right, let's look back at some of the action from that previous round, DC. How about you? All right, both fighters now ready to go with round two.
Okay, ready, round
Israel
two.
Adesanya. Ready. And that man, John Jones. Ooh, blocks the shot. So at long last, he finally lands his first takedown after several failed attempts. You knew coming in that he was going to stay committed to the takedown, kept on trying, and finally got him to the ground.
Now it's his mount.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
If you're the bottom fighter, DC, what do you do?
You got to move, you got to shrimp, you got to get off on a hip to try to move your opponent off of you or pull him down to close the space.
Man, how fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground and pound?
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people up in the ground and pound. This guy is a throwback fighter, and he's very fun to watch.
Yeah, the Godfather would be proud. All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
Just reached the midway point of the fight. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Oh, he postured up there, gained some valuable separation.
And now the ground and pound starts.
All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Oh, and he's able to land a strike there from the bottom. Nicely done by Adesanya. Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
A lot of top pressure being applied here. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Pretty good ground and pound by him here. He told us on Thursday he needed to be more effective in these situations. Certainly effective tonight.
Many people have gone away from this style of fighting. This man has embraced it, and you are seeing why. He's one of the best that we've seen do it in a long time.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head, or he's going to get blasted.
Two rounds in the books.
Last round, guys. You ready?
Let's go. Third round underway. Jones going for the takedown here, but he misses. Well, he told you off the top he had the reach advantage, and you saw it right there with that punch. Just missed with the elbow there. Slips the punch nicely there.
Nice entry into the finish direct.
Well, he's more than content to work off of his back, DC, where he has been a magician in his UFC career. Working off of his back here, looks like he may try to hip escape. All right, side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. I love watching this guy move on the ground. Another nice transition there.
Such a high-level grappler. You don't see that very often.
Well, he is completely gassed at this stage of the fight. I'm not sure if he's lost his will to continue, but might be time to just put that controller down and take a breather.
I mean, he's going to keep pressing those buttons as long as he can. You got to get him out of there if you're winning. Because he's going to try to take him down. There you go.
Oh, how about the slam there? That one cannot feel good. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Good movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground tonight.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent in every transition.
66 total strikes have landed for Johnny Bones Jones. And unofficially landing with 51% accuracy against him.
Actually got the takedown.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up. Well, you've got to admire the urgency here. He is trying to keep the judges out of it, lighting up his opponent left and right. Try to establish that jab.
Big.
Whoa! Crazy accuracy and efficiency with these ground and pound strikes here for the opponent. You've got to intelligently defend or the referee's going to stop. So have we, your winner by TKO.
That was a great performance. Way to land those strikes and go and chase down the finish when you get an opportunity.
right, DC, no Telestrator tonight, but we're going to get you some highlights from this one. This was a fight. Now we go inside the octagon.